ke dumedisa bana ba modimo ke medisa ka ofela modimo le sofatse na go ge fitile na go ri lora twana ka yona gore ka 1 o'clock ke tlaba ke sera lentse la modimo ebile se di fitile ka metsotso kile wa baka podiso kile wa baka healing ke tlaba ya ka letsatsi la nase re bolela ka podiso ke nyaka go bala lentse la modimo bukung ya Samuel wa bobedi 2 Samuel chapter 10 ke bala Bible ya King James verse 4 2 Samuel chapter 10 verse 4 and verse 5 wherefore Hanun took David's servants and shaved off half of their beards and cut off their garments in the middle even to the buttocks and sent them away. When they told it unto David, he sent to meet them, because the men were greatly ashamed. And the king said, tarry at Jericho until your beards be grown, and then return. Kinyaka ubalaka Bible translation ya NLT ere. So Hanun sees David's envoys, shaved off half of each man's beard, cut off their garments at their buttocks, and sent them away in shame. When thus was reported to David, he sent messengers to meet the men, since they have been thoroughly humiliated. The king told them, stay in Jericho until your beards have grown back, and then return. Ke rata o leboga modimo ka lengwalo le re le badile letsatsi la nase chapter re di badilego Bible e tlhalosa ka se selo sa direga. Bible e tlhalosa gore e khosi ya setšhaba se e tlhokofetse, morwa wa khosi a tšea bogosi gore e be yena moetapele. Bible e tlhalosa gore khosi Dafita e a ikwa gore khosi Hanuni o tlhokofetse, e Dafita a ikwa gore o beilwe morwa wa khosi leatong la khosi, a romela batho gore batho ba ye ba mo gomotse, a romela batho gore batho ba ye ba mo lise ka ge a be a le ka gare ya botlhoko, a kwele botlhoko, a gobetse. Bible e tlhalosa gore ge banna ba ba fitha ba romilwe ke khosi o isa molaetsa wa go llisa khosi, o fodisa khosi ka ra bothoko yo khosi a be o a bokwele ka ge a tlhokofaletswe ke tatagwe a dutse leatong la tatagwe. Bible re ge banna bao ba fitha ya ba baeletsi ba khosi ba botsa khosi ba re khosi o seke wa nagana gore banna ba ba tiile mowe o tla o gomotsa ka re a bothoko bjo bokwelego, o seka nagana gore ba tiile o fodisa ka ge o ikwa bothoko, ba ka ba e le dithodi ba tlile o nyaka o lekolanaga gore ba re tsiele naga. Bible re e khosi a ikwa magele, Hanun a ikwa magele a batlhanka ba gagwe ba ba moeleditseo, a tsea maele ao gomme a tshwara banna ba o romiwa ke Dafita. Bebele re ba kutiwa ditedu tsa bona, ba buša gape ba ripiwa dikobo tsa bona, ba sala e kare a ba apara selo, ba sala ba jesa dithoni. Bible e tlhalosa gore banna bao ba gomela morao gore ba e ba keponagatse pele ya khosi bjalo ka ge ba be ba romilwe. Bible e re ba rile ba sesiwa fitha mo Dafita a be o gona, Dafita a ba a setse a kwele. Ke rata mantswe a e re they were greatly humiliated. Dafita a utwa gore banna bawe ba nyenyefaditswe, banna bawe ba dirilwe dilo tsa dithoni a ba lebelelei, ba setse e ka re a ba apara ba kutilwe ditedu, ba buša ba kgeilelwa dikobo tsa bona le mafilong ao e le gore a di sa di thoni monna a tshwanela gore a tsamaye a sa apara. Bibele re ta fita e kwa a botsa banna bao a re le seke la fita moo, yane le ye le thome le dule Jericho. Le tla re ge ditelo tja lena di godile, le tla re ye le apere la kgona le boya. Ngwane se letšatši lena a se re apa ka phodiso. Mo bophelone re tlhakana le maemo ao re tlhakana le ona mo bophelone a re sia e le gore we are greatly ashamed. A re sia e le gore e ka re we are so naked, a re lebelelei. Mo bophelone re tlhakana le maemo ao a re sia o re kwela bothoko. Ke dumela ga botse gore Dafita o be a tsebile ebile a tseba taba ya bothoko bjo morwa wa kgosi a ka bao a be a bokwele. Ore morwa wa kgosi e a tlhokofalete ke bopapawe, he is still mourning, he is still in pain, o utlwa bothoko. O tlhoka gore a fiwe molaetsa wa phodiso, o tlhoka gore a batamelwe kgauswi gore a fole ka ra bothoko bja gagwe. But Bible e bontšha gore morwa wa kgosi a eletswa ke batho ba ba ile go ba moeletša, ba be boo ba le kgauswi le yena. Bibele re ba moeletša ka tsela yeo e sa lokago ka baka la gore morwa wa kgosi o be a tlhoka a discerning spirit, moya wa o kgona to discern all the advices tse ba mo fao tsona. A seke a lemoga gore ba mo dirisa diphoso, a seke a lemoga gore ba mo dirisa dilo tseo di sa lokago. Maele a bona a se maele a mabotse, maele a bona a se maele a o tla o mo aisa, a se maele a o tla o dira gore a be le tlhokagano ye botse le Dafita. Ke ka moo a tsere dikgato tja gore banna bawe ba beo ba romilwe a ba humiliate, a ba sietše ka rego a ba apara. Ngwaneso, ge motho a le ka gare a bothoko, ge re thakane le maemo ao e le gore o ka re ona we need healing, re tlhoka phodiso, re tshwanetse gore re be le the spirit of discernment. Discern gore o eletswa ke batho ba mohuta mane, ke bomane batho bawe bao ba tlamela o ba bolela le wena when you are going through pain, ke bomane batho bawe ba o fa maele when you have experienced a loss in your life, o eletswa ke bomane. Some people they are like these guys ba gore e morwa kgosi while he was mourning the death of his father, ba mo eletsa ka tsela ya o seloke, ba mo eletsa ka tsela ya gore a senye le go feta. It's very important to heal when we are going through pain. It's very important to heal when we are going through difficulties. And how can we heal? Check the surrounding. Batho ba bangwe, they are not there to bring healing. They are there to inflict you more with pain. Ba tlile go ba tlhakatlhakantshe maemo le go feta. Discern the kind of advices that you get from people around you when you are going through difficult times. Hanuni amesa ntho e botlhokwa, amesa to discern gore maele a ba mo fa ona ke maele a mohuta mane, maele a ba mo fa ona ke maele awe a ka kgona go thusa bophelo ba gagwe na, maele a ba mo fa ona ke maele awe a ka dira gore a be le kgokagano le kgosi Dafita na. Go na le batho ba ba weletsa because they are hurt. And when they are hurt, even when they advise you from the depth of their pain. Ba ueletsa o tswa le ka mo ba ubetsiwe ka gona, ba ka se ueletsa ka botse because these people they are broken inside. Discern the kind of advices tse batho ba o fa o tsona. What kind of advices are they? Maele a ba o fa ona a tswa from what kind of spirit, what kind of fountain are these advices coming from? He motho a gobetse o tlhoka gore a fole. If you don't heal from the pain, you are likely to inflict other people with pain because you are not hurt. If you don't heal from pain, you are likely to collect all sorts of bad advices because you are still in pain. You need healing when you go through difficulties. You need healing when you go through challenging times. You need healing. Dilo tse dingwe e o etswe ka ramaemo a o thata fa, don't be in a rush. Don't be in a rush. Maybe relationship a ya šoma gabotse. You were in a relationship, things did not go all right. Things did not work in the right way, the way you expected. A o a tshwanela gore o kitimele to the next relationship while you are still wounded, while you are still in pains, while you are still you need to heal before you move to the next relationship. You need to heal before you take the next step, because if you get into the next relationship with the past wounds, usanali, hey, the Bible says, "Kale," you are going to damage, to destroy the same relationship that you are in a rush for. Because you are still wounded, you are not healed. We need to heal and accept. When you are going through difficult times, accept that I'm hurt. Accept that I'm going through pain. I need to heal. I need to settle down. There should be that time of settling down. Udule fasi amogela gore I need to heal. I just need to heal. Tshele tamantsi atafeta tafeta ikwa gore banna ba hawe ba ditjwe ba gutse dikubo aba libelelei ibile ba gutilwe ditedu uri mo bona uri go and stay in Jericho. Young lelule Jericho, don't come to us while you are wounded like that. Don't come to us while you are in pains like that, because you will cause harm among other people. But ba mangwa bataba bataba le litshogo bata go bala ka bakala lena. Go and stay in Jericho until you are healed. When you are healed, it's where then you can come back. It's where then you can resurface again, because you are healed. Then Linzule Lauri, Jericho. Jericho is a place of retirement. Jericho is a place of concealment. When you go through difficult times, you should have your own Jericho. You should have a place where you can say, I'm here to retire, to hide myself until I heal. Therefore, when I'm healed, I shall go out. I shall resurface when I'm healed. Many times, guys, ministries because we are hurt. You are from the ministry where you have been hurt. You have been hurt for a long time, and now you are starting a ministry so that you can compensate on what they did unto you. Ministry ukase sepile ka botse. If you start a ministry ga di wounds je go be go le tsona. Ministry ukase sepile bona, you cannot even teach, you cannot even preach the word. Every time you stand up, you speak like a wounded soldier. A u bulele bophelo because you are hurt and you are not healed. Even the people that will follow you, because keba fall, you are bleeding as well. When they touch your garment, they cannot assess healing because you are also wounded, you are in pains. Usikewa tomadilo while you are still bleeding. Wait for the time. Go and hide in Jericho like this man until your beds have developed, until your body is covered. Therefore, you will be able to resurface and preach a powerful message. Usikewa dira dilo while you are still wounded. Take your time. You need to heal first. This man is healed. Even you don't even have to mention where I was wounded. Hey, you go panel challenges this and that. No. When you speak from the place of maturity because you are healed. Ufodile from the pain that you went through. Ufodile from the hurt, from the rejection that you went through. It is very dangerous to speak while you are still bleeding. Because you will inflict other people. Udo confuse abantu, udo taka taka nchawa, udo taguba chawa tu baba mwe. You need to heal. Mabu pironi riaguba achwa. But there should be a time of healing. Utoma ufole piluru mudimu. I just need to heal. I just need to heal. Mpodise mabadi. Kikuwa butuku mpodise. Mpodise butuku kibu uka arabana. Dafita uru men. Yes, I know. You are embarrassed. Hey, but wait. Heal first. Go and hide in Jericho. Where is Jericho? Our Jericho is Jesus Christ. You just surrender your life to Christ and say, Father, I am hurt. I'm bleeding. I'm in pain. Heal me, Lord, before I appear before other people. Heal me, Lord, so that I can go out and preach a powerful message. Mpodise pele ke kwa gara relationship dilo. Ani asipila, uska start a relationship because you want to settle scores, you want to prove, uprovela your ex or wena usaratwa, uprovela the man that left you, the woman that left you, that wena waratwa. Hey, if you are in a hurry, in such a hurry for a relationship, you are likely to fall into the other pit again. because you are not healed. And about to also fall, even when they are in a new relationship, they speak about the past. Ke ba Israel ba tswa ba le gebeta modimo ba ntshitse gebeta ba tshwere leeto ba lebile kanana. But guess what are they saying? These people ba bulela ka gebeta ba ntshitswe gebeta mara ka mo go bona, they are still bleeding, they are still in pains, they are not healed. Even when God is performing miracles, even when God is feeding them, they were not satisfied. Why? Because they were still bleeding. Ba ba sa kwa botlhoko, ba ba sa fola. We need to heal. Productive if we are bleeding. We need to heal so that our community can be healed. We need to heal so that our surrounding can change. When you are healed, you come to a point whereby even the atmosphere will change because you are healed. When they stand up and speak, they speak. And after speaking, because these people, they are not healed. How fodile o fodisa le batho ba bangwe. How fodile batho ba bangwe ba o tieletsa. They receive healing because you are healed. Ore dafita or go and stay in Jericho until you are healed. Tomane le fole pele. Heal. Heal first. You need healing. You need to be healed. You need your healing. It might be emotional healing. Today, ogano ba ukopan le maema ubadi chewa guori ki ubechi bambu di chelo chau baba ki ubechi. But don't despise your healing, because it is your healing that will carry you. Give position ya how yeta udira uruwemele la urumudimo. Now I can stand because I am healed. You need to hide in Jericho as well. Kutanya na urumudimo. Hide me, heal me. I'm broken. Heal me, my Father. Sometimes we even engage ourselves in unnecessary debates. Oh, Mudimo, Mudimo karakari tusa, unnecessary arguments because we are not healed. And when we speak, we don't speak life because we are not healed. You need to heal, my brother. You need to heal, my sister. It has happened. Yes, we know. Riatseba didiregile, but accept it has happened. Didiregala batukamo kakabona. You might say my situation is beyond this man of God, he doesn't know my situation. But hey, I'm telling you, you need to heal. When you are healed, you will create an atmosphere of peace in your surrounding because you are healed as well. Ufodile moyeng wa hao. Ufodile moyeng wa hao. Unale bophelo. Ska dumelela. Usipela ubeju. Ska dumelela uthomadilo. Just because unyaka one sabatori, you can rise again. No. You need to heal and say, Father, help me to stand. Help me in the name of Jesus. The center of the message of the Bible is healing. The 70 disciples. Go. Tsenane motse ka motse. Tsenane ditoropo le rere. Le fodise le balwetse. The ministry of healing is the ministry of Jesus Christ. And is our ministry. He gave us the ministry to heal. And he said to them, freely you have given and freely give. For he said, cast out the demons because this is our ministry. The ministry of healing. And how can we heal? We heal when we lay hands. We heal when we preach the word. Even now as I'm preaching, I believe you are receiving your healing because this is our ministry. The Bible says by his stripes we are healed. Kadi mapulo cha morana Jesu rifodile kama neba kama badi amorana Jesu rifodile. Peter ore, we are healed. It's not something that is going to come, it's something that has already taken place. Risaji rifodile. Now we are healed by the stripes of Jesus Christ. Sometimes you need to declare your healing. Even when you feel pains, you just stand and say, I'm healed in the name of Jesus. Kifodile, you pain. This is your territory. I'm a child of God. I'm healed in the name of Jesus. The ministry of healing is the ministry of Christ. The ministry of healing is our ministry. We are sent to heal. We are sent to speak the word. We are sent to preach the word. We are sent to lay hands on the sick. And the Bible says they shall recover. They shall be healed. Kim ministry wa morana Jesu wa ufodisa. Kim ministry wa morana Jesu wa ulukulla. Oh, ministry wa morana Jesu, a powerful ministry is the ministry that we are running today. The ministry of healing. Ona wa morana Jesu, arifile wona. You need your healing, your special healing. In every area of your life, you need your healing. No wonder the man of God, Afita Kwetor Meti, Meti Ababa, Bible Ire, Achialitwai, Achalakara Meti, and the water suddenly Meti Afetura, Meti Abama Buti. This is the ministry of healing. Give ministry. Wow, for this, give ministry. Wow, local, like one ministry. Our Mudimo, Arifilo, if you don't heal, you are likely to be bitter. When they speak, they are full of bitterness because something is not good inside. How can I know that I'm healed? You can only know that you are healed if you can be able to preach the message of reconciliation. Ugasirera message wa reconciliation if you are still bleeding. Ugasirera message wa reconciliation, and you cannot reconcile with other people if you are still bleeding. You need to heal. When you are healed, you can be able to reconcile others. You can be able to tell people that, hey, here's the message of reconciliation. Under reconciliation, there is forgiveness. Under reconciliation, there is love. Under reconciliation, there is perseverance. How can we do this? If only you are healed. That are not healed, but it must not be you. You need to heal. But wa manjiri te chika batu li pilung tari. Na ubala bala gabatu, ubule la gabatu. Bandiri lane, yes. Ba udiri le, but forgive them. How can you forgive them? Be healed in Jesus' mighty name. Fala, ubechi, but you need your healing. Utoka ru fala from that pain, from that hurt, mudimu. Autu se uluku luge. Then you will be able to heal other people. Le batuwa ngaba ubatame, le batore. I was not like this, but since kimu batame echi, I am healed. Tele tamu sadikyo. Bible ruba falala madi, are if only I can touch the hem of his garment. I ramurana Jesus. Bible just by touching the hem of his garment, madi awe ahema, musadi alukuluwa, just by touching. Oh, mo auna puleri sano, they don't, auna puleri sano, awuleri limurana Jesus, but just by touching the hem of his garment, Bible madi awe ahema. Why? Because Christ is our healing. Christ is our healing. Kie na morana Jesu. Podiso yari na. Kie na morana Jesu. Tukulo yari na. If there is any area that is lacking in your life, where you need healing, I'm challenging you today. As I'm going to pray as well. Your healing is here. By the stripes of Jesus, we are healed. Herbala lintina mudimu. Exodus chapter 15 verse 26. Lintina mudimu lere. For I am the Lord that healeth thee. Kina mudimu yo alifodisa hao. And now tell it to have to move him or a helica to a lady to take a mugarachona. Let to a lady to la chalina. Let to a lady to la jaha beta. La sepila galin chulaga. Get a tibinama retica mugaha beta. For I am the Lord that healeth thee. Kinamudimu your way. Ali for the sow. Kinamudimu your way. Ali look allow. Hevala in Silamudimu Matthew chapter 4, verse 23. Bible iri. Jesu atena mitana limitana. Aeta for isa iri all manner of disease malwetika ofela ube a for isa because this is the ministry of healing. Give ministry wa podiso. Give ministry wa urilukuluge podiso ewona moyeng wa gao podiso ewona miling wa gao kalibitso lele matla la morena Jesu Kriste mudima ka for isa luwena letsatsila nase herebala James chapter 5 verse 6 Bible ire, therefore confess your sins one to another. Confess your sins one to another so that you may be healed. Sometimes you are not healed because ribulukile dilo ka ra dipelo tsa rena. We don't want to let go. We don't want to let go unforgiveness. Arinya ke ulesa, arinya ke ulukolla batho dipelong tsa rena. Arinya ke go lebalela. Ri rueli batho dipelong tsa rena. That's the reason. We cannot heal, we cannot be healed. Habutsubutsu wena, you are not inflicted by the things there from outside. Maraka rapilu ya hao. He ukalumela dilo tse modimo a sarinya go tsa tswa ka rapilu ya hao. It's where you will experience the peace of God. Utaka wena likhutso o fodile. If you can only let go. Rena ka modimo a re thuse, but we are, our hands are so full. Re ta modimo ni ri tswere dilo.
Le modimo re let go, we don't want to let go. But I'm encouraging you today, just let go. Tongela dilo tsa khale, tongela. Tongela di tongela mo ba o ba di tse ona, tongela. Let go everything and say, Father, heal me, I just want to be healed. Heal me, I want to be delivered from this. O tla go tsiya modimo. E o lebaletse, e o dirile lo ka mo ka o sepela ka lentshila modimo. Even when you look at your enemies, you love them. Bona mona ile bona mana ba ba, you love them. Because in you, there is no bitterness, there is no hatred. You are a child of God. Igari mudimo, I go for this from whatever you are going through right now. I speak healing upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak healing that the hand of God may touch you right now. In Jesus' mighty name, let the presence of God fall upon your life. And I thank God for this opportunity. I thank God for this time that we have together to share the word. May God bless you in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father.